Well, shalom, ESC family. It's Andrew coming at you today with our weekly announcements. First of all, I just want to say what a blessing it was to have everybody together this past Sunday for Shavuot as we gathered for Pentecost and prayed for a refreshing of the Holy Spirit and prayed for healing in our land from racial divides. It was just a blessed time seeing all of you in community, and we look forward to gathering again this coming Shabbat. I do want to give us just a couple of quick announcements this week for our upcoming Shabbat service. We've had several emails and calls asking about details of this service. We will be meeting in person at El Shaddai, 206 East 4th Street, Frederick, Maryland, 21701. Our services begin at 10:15 a.m., just like our old schedule. A few differences that you will see is we probably won't have greeters at the door or greeters on our way out. We still will be maintaining guidelines for some social distancing while still gathering together. We will have masks available as well as hand sanitizer stations. And we would ask at this time that as a community, we would take our temperature before we come into the community. And if we're running a fever of 100 or above, that we would stay home and join in with our online services for this coming weekend. I also want to let you know that for our offering this week, we'll have two baskets available up front that you can be able to leave an offering or in the tzedakah boxes in the back of the sanctuary. Also, for our kids, at this time, we're not reinstating children's classes just yet on Shabbats. Let's continue praying for more things to continue opening up and that we can have some good guidelines in place for sanitation and making sure all of our kids stay super healthy. At this time, we're going to ask families to stay together and sit together in the sanctuary for service. So parents, from the time you come into the building to the time you leave, we ask that your kids would stay with you. We know this is hard as we love the freedom for our kids to be able to run around, but we just ask that families would stay together. Again, we also will be live streaming the entire service if that's easier for you in this season. Also, I want to let you know that next Shabbat, June 13th, will be Pastor Todd and Pastor Deborah's last Shabbat with us before their three-month sabbatical. First of all, we all know how much we love them, and I just want to encourage you, let's be praying for them in this season for rest and rejuvenation and just time with the Lord and with one another. Next week, the 13th, we will be having a basket out. If you get something from the Lord, if the Lord gives you a word of encouragement for them over the summer, you'd like to give them a card or a gift, we will have a basket in the foyer for you that you can leave one for them, and we'll make sure they take them with them on their sabbatical. Lastly, I just want to be able to lead us in a time of prayer and encourage us. Yeshua summed up all the law and the prophets in two things. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, and mind. And the second is like it, to love your neighbor as yourself. I'm sure you don't have to go very far. You probably can go in your Facebook feed right above this video or right below it and see a lot of political statements right now between racial divide, about COVID, about conspiracy theories. There's a lot of hatred going on. And there's also just a lot of politics going on. And I just want to pray for us. This is an opportunity for us in this season to stand with our community, with the Black community in America, and be able to lift up our arms with them, to be able to hold them, to be able to cry with them and pray with them. So I just want to lead us in a prayer for this right now. Hallelujah. Avinu Malkeinu, our Father, our King, we bless you. Lord, we just thank you for your love for us. We thank you for your love for all peoples. Lord, I just thank you for specifically the calling of the Jewish people being a light to nations. Lord, I just thank you for the opportunity we have right now to be a light to nations, Lord, to different people groups. Lord, I just pray that you would give us the heart of the Father. Lord, I pray that you would just fill us with your Holy Spirit, Lord, as we just came through Pentecost. Lord, refill us with your Holy Spirit. Lord, give us supernatural love, supernatural grace to be able to walk through these times together as community. We thank you, Yeshua, for your love for us. We thank you that we are one new man in you, in Messiah Yeshua. Lord, we thank you. There's no male or female. Lord, there's no Jew or Gentile. There's no black or white. Lord, we are together. And Lord, I pray that you would give us courage in this hour, that you would give us love. Lord, that we would hear one another, that we would stand with one another. And Lord, above all, that we would love one another. Lord, we thank you that you have the ability to heal and restore today. B'Shem Yeshua. Amen. Lord bless you. I look forward to seeing all of you this coming Shabbat. And until then, Shalom.